morning. So in this video, I will be removing my shellac colour that is over a build gel. This has been on now for about 5 weeks, so ideally you wouldn't leave this amount of time between your appointment, but obviously because this is my own set, I haven't had a chance to do them. So as you can see, there's quite a lot of regrowth on them and quite a lot of cuticle, especially on this one here, quite a big buildup of hard skin on my sidewalls. But I'm actually going to do a separate video on this using my Katie Barnes tool range. So I'll put that up at a later date. And as you can also see here, I have broken, as you can see here, I've broken the tip of this one here. So I am going to do another video on how I will extend that using C&D's Plexi Gel. So all these nails will then be
even. I'm going to show you the e-file that I will be using. This was actually bought from the Nail Tech Network. And I'd seen this on there. I'll just show you that. So I'd seen this on there and a lot of people had been recommending it and, you know, rating it quite highly. So I thought I'd have a look.
I think if you're new to e-filing and you don't want to spend a fortune, this is perfect for you. So depending on what you would like to use your e-file for, it will determine the bits that you need to. So I don't actually like to use my e-file to do any cuticle work. I've got no issues with anybody that does choose to use it for this purpose. I personally prefer to use my cuticle tools for prep so I don't cause any unnecessary damage to the cuticle area or matrix. Obviously, if you aren't trained in using e-file, you shouldn't be using it as you can cause untold damage if you do use it incorrectly. So all of my videos that I am going to be posting currently will be for advice and tips on how I work and things that I've picked up along the way that may benefit other nail techs new to the industry or people looking at starting a career or any experienced techs already in the industry that want to look at perhaps a different perspective or a different technique. They aren't actually to teach at present. However, I am completing my award in education training, which is otherwise known as an AET. I will be looking into putting courses together to offer as a face-to-face and online, although I would also like to complete my DET, also known as Level 5 Diploma in Education and Training, because the AET is really only an introduction into teaching. So moving back to the e-file, so as I say, this is how it comes on the back. You've got a little clip here, so if you want to attach it to, if you've got an apron or anything, or a belt or anything, you can attach it to that. And then obviously you've got your settings here, which I'll go through in a little bit more detail in a moment. So these are the two main bits that I use. As I say, I haven't got a vast array of bits because at the moment I only use it for debulking. So this one here is the one that I use to debulk. So you've got like different teeth in it, so that's really good at debulking. And then I've also got this one here, which is really good for making that shape here underneath the C curve. It gives you a nice C curve. You don't always really need to use that, but it is a handy one to have. So you would only really use these if a client has an enhancement on under their polish. So with me, I have got my Plexi Gel underneath this. I haven't just got shellac. If you had got a client that had just got shellac, then you would only need to use a soak off. You would not use an e-file on their nails for this. And again, I have got a separate video for a shellac removal, which you can have a look
at.
These two bits of my e-file, I think, cost about £130 off the top of my head, which included the VAT and delivery, which I think ideally, you don't really want to be spending any less, or the machine and the bits that you're getting probably aren't going to be that good. So I'm referring to like the cheap kits that you can buy off eBay. They're probably not going to be very good. They might look cheap and good, but I really would probably steer clear. So I'm actually looking at purchasing some more bits for me to use for refining the shape and application, and to obviously get a little bit closer to the cuticle area. So as I say, I only really debulk at the moment, but I will be looking at getting extra bits to refine, work around the cuticle area and just speed up my treatment time really. Because at the moment, I generally tend to take between an hour and a half to 2 hours to do like a full set of acrylics, which is fine. Obviously, if there's any nail art, sometimes it can be a little bit longer. And also depending on the client's cuticles, that can obviously take a little bit longer, but generally as a rule I'm looking at about 2 hours for a full set, and then an hour and a half usually for an infill. Again, if it's a lot of cuticle work, then it does take me longer. And also I'm finding at the moment, because of COVID and things,
we are having a lot of time in between, so when people are coming back, it is an infill, but the nails are quite long, so it is a longer process, the infill.
I'm just going to show you on here. So this machine has a forward setting and a reverse setting. Okay, so what it does, it means that you can alter the direction the e-file, the bit itself, is actually moving. Okay, so this area here, this one, it controls your speed. So I know some of them come up with like numbers and things, but obviously this doesn't. So you would turn this round to get your e-file bit moving at a particular speed. So when I'm working with my e-file, I would always work in the opposite direction to the way that the e-file is spinning. Otherwise, as you're using it, it will just spin over the nail. Okay, so if I just show you this actually, you twist, it's already open, and then you pop your bit in, and then you twist it, okay, and then that's it in place. So I'm just going to turn this on just to show you. You probably can't see, but so that's spinning. So this is on a forward setting, so it is spinning clockwise. So if it is spinning in a clockwise direction, I would then work in an anti-clockwise direction. So I'm working against the way that the speed of the file is going, because if I was to go in the same direction, it would just slip over the top of it, which obviously you don't want to do. So you need to be working at a speed that is comfortable for you, and obviously a speed that is going to be effective enough to remove the product, and always keep your file moving in one direction. So you would never have your e-file and keep it on one spot. You would need to constantly be moving that e-file, picking it up and moving it, okay? Because if you keep it in one spot, you are going to create a heat source in that area where the friction is, and that's going to be really quite uncomfortable for the client, okay? So, you know, you do need to be making sure that you're always moving it. And please bear in mind that if you are doing a full removal, you would only take down so much before you would soak the remaining product, okay? So a lot of the time under acrylics, you would put a clear base, and then if they're having a different colour acrylic, then you would file that acrylic down to the clear base. Or a lot of my ladies tend to have a core powder and then the gel polish. So what I would do is I would just remove the gel polish and then infill that core powder. If you were doing a complete and utter removal, you would then take it down most of the way, and then you would soak off the remaining. You would never go right up to that nail plate, because you could then damage. I've seen in the past a lot of techs where they go too close here, and then you get what's called the ring of fire. So you get an indentation here on people's nails as they start to grow up, and it's quite an obvious one, because they've gone on the nail plate, they've filed on the nail plate, and it's caused the ring of fire basically. Okay, so I would work the edges first. So I would work this area, and I would work this way, so I'd come round, and then I would work around the cuticle area, and then I would also work this way, and then I would use the file and I would take it down, and that would debulk the nail, and then I'd move on to the next one. Okay, so if you wanted to remove a lot of length, I would advise, so if somebody had come and they've got really, really long nails and you wanted to take them down to here, I have seen people, I have seen it where they obviously hold it vertically and then come across with their e-file. But if you bring quite a lot down, then what I would probably recommend is using some toenail clippers just at the side, nip the nail at the side, and then it will take a lot of the bulk off. I wouldn't use the tip cutters, because if you were to use the tip cutters, you'll probably find that you'll get a split down the actual acrylic. So I am going to obviously remove all the varnish on this hand here. So I'll show you that in a moment. I'll stop talking. I'll put it on fast time so that it speeds it up. And you can see the way that I work. Obviously, again, if you were removing this varnish here and underneath the product that you'd got on underneath, I mean, to be fair, Plexigel, I don't really have any lifting with the Plexigel, but if you were to remove this and there was a slight bit of lifting, what you would do is you would have your e-file set further back than the actual lifting. You wouldn't do it on top of the lifting, you would do it here, and then what that would do is as you go across, it would just ping that lifting off, so you're not again getting anywhere near the natural nail, and you're not going to damage that natural nail. So okay. Before I start, I'm just going to obviously just discuss with you briefly, when you use an e-file, you do need a dust extraction. So this is the one that I've got. You can't see it fully obviously in this video, but you do need a dust extraction to be able to keep the dust from sort of going around the room.
if I'm doing a mobile client, I have mentioned in my previous video, I've got a nail desk that's got it's a portable nail desk and it's got a built-in extraction unit. But when I'm working from home, I use this one. It is okay. It's not the best. It cost me about £60. So it does suck in a lot of the dust. But we do have a little bit of overspray. So when I've finished, I will show you, you know, what's sort of left over so you can see for yourself. I am looking at getting, I would quite like a Vodex, but again, it's quite costly and bulky. And with me working from my kitchen, it's not really something that I can store when I'm not using it. So it's not something that I'm going to be getting at the moment. Again, you should obviously have your PPE on. So if you're doing a client, it should be the correct mask if you're doing enhancements. Obviously I don't need my mask on at the moment because I'm not going to wear my mask because I'm doing myself, so it's fine. And I will put my dust extraction on, so I'm going to get right into it and I'm going to film me removing my varnish and you can see how I would do that process. Okay, so I'm going to start by turning on my dust extraction, and then I'll just show you one here. So I'm actually going to turn this setting sort of to around here really, so that it's got enough speed. So you can see that's taken me 4 minutes, or just over 4 minutes, to do that. That's one hand. Obviously it's taken me slightly longer because I've done it on myself. It would be a lot quicker if I was doing it on a client. And again, just brush off the dust. So you can see on the machine, it's actually taken in quite a lot of the dust. It's just a little bit of overspray. And again, that's because I'm holding my hand up like that, whereas a client would have it over the top. So it is a fairly good extractor. It's just obviously not as powerful as the other ones. And obviously with it being domed, it's not a flat surface and there's only a certain, whereas the other ones, it's a bigger surface of a fan to draw it in. So as I say, you can see, but I've removed all those, so you can see my plexi gel underneath, and that's how you would remove with an e-file. So if you do have any questions or would like to know any of the information on the products that I've used, please don't hesitate. And as mentioned already, I will be doing a separate video on my cuticle prep on these, infilling them and the redesign. So be sure to like and subscribe to catch my next video, and once again, thanks for watching.